In this video, we'll see the recipe of super moist decadent chocolate cake. And yes, it's a no-bake cake because it's a steamed cake. Let's get started. To a bowl, add 1/4 cup milk. The milk should be at room temperature. Now add 1/4 cup yogurt or curd. This is our regular curd or dahi which does not have any sugar in it. Give it a whisk. And now add 1/4 cup oil. So I'm using cooking oil. You need to use any neutral cooking oil. So this is not extra virgin olive oil. It's extra light olive oil from Dasano. If you add extra virgin olive oil or coconut or peanut oil, it would overpower the taste of the cake. So don't do that. Now take 3/4 cup powdered sugar. This is a regular sugar which you need to grind in mixer grinder. And after that, you need to measure 3/4 cup. Now let's mix the dry ingredients. So 1 cup all-purpose flour or maida, 1.5 tablespoon cocoa powder. It's unsweetened, it does not have any sugar. 1 teaspoon baking powder, 1/4 teaspoon baking soda, and a pinch of salt in this chocolate cake. Mix everything using a spoon or a whisk. Now gradually add this dry mixture to the wet mixture. Make sure you do not overmix the batter, just until you get a smooth batter, and a use of whisk would ease this process and would make it quick. Just at the end, fold with the spatula like 2 to 3 times and then transfer to a cake tin. I'm using a 5-inch cake tin, but you can also use a 6-inch cake tin for this recipe. Cover with an aluminum foil, and like I said in my custard recipe, you can also use a steel tiffin or dabba which already has a lid on it. So instead of the foil, you will have the lid. Now put it in your steamer, which should have water boiling inside it, and steam it just like dhokla or idli for 40 minutes at high flame or between medium to high. So I'll repeat, it's just like steaming the idli or dhokla. Now after that, let this cake cool down. To make the ganache, take 1/2 cup whipping cream. I'm using non-dairy, and now I'm going to heat it. Do not directly put it on your gas stove or induction, it will curdle. So I'm going to microwave it for a few seconds. You can use a double boiler method, also called as water bath. So you heat or boil water in a bowl and place this bowl on top and then let the cream heat. I microwaved this cream for 15 to 20 seconds and I stirred it in between. Now adding 1 cup dark chocolate. I'm using Morde dark chocolate. I'm not using compound, but you can use compound. Putting it back in my microwave, but as I said, you can continue mixing it on your double boiler or water bath setup. If you do not have non-dairy cream, you can also use Amul fresh cream. Make sure you use its thick part. And let this ganache cool down after mixing it well. After keeping this ganache in refrigerator, not freezer, for 30 minutes, it's time to whip it. Now, if you use Amul's fresh cream, the result would not be what you see on the screen. It would not be that fluffy, but still the ganache would be tasty. Scrape the sides of bowl in between and whip the ganache well. Look at the beautiful shiny ganache. The cake has also cooled down and now it's time to decorate it. Just loosen the sides using a knife and then flip it over to take out the cake. In this cake, I'm not going to use any simple syrup or any kind of syrup to make this cake moist, because the steamed cake is already super duper moist and it's beautiful. So just using some cream ganache on my cake board, but you can directly place it on your plate, any kind of plate which you have at home. Now apply some ganache on all the sides of the cake. Make sure you keep this layer thin, and it's okay if the finishing is not well, because now I'm going to pipe some ganache on this cake. Looks beautiful and tempting already, but the next step is to make some design. So here I've got nozzle number 12, but it's basically just round nozzle, round tip. But if you do not have this, you can simply cut your piping bag Do not use any nozzle and make the same design. If you would have seen my red velvet cake recipe, I have used the same design, and I think in that video I have not used any piping nozzle. Very simple design, yet it looks very beautiful. This is nozzle number 103, the rose petal nozzle. Beautiful shiny ganache and super moist steamed cake, absolutely divine. I'll just take out a slice and show you. I hope you like this recipe. Give it a try and enjoy.